Today, three more members of a white supremacy group are under arrest, charged with hate crimes.
And today, we're learning more about their alleged plot. WESH 2 flew over the American Front's compound today. Investigators say this is where they trained in firearms and hand-to-hand combat. They plotted acts of violence at places like Orlando City Hall and even talked about manufacturing their own deadly poison.
WESH 2's Amanda Ober joins us live right now with the new details. And Amanda, this compound could have served as a military base.
According to the arrest warrant that I obtained earlier today, the leader of this group had plans to turn his property into an Aryan compound, a place that his group members could live when the United States government fails. Now, the details of this group's alleged hatred for minorities and their preparations to use violence against them is, to say the least, disturbing. Three of the most recently arrested members of a white supremacist group were held in cages in the back of the room as they appeared before a judge Tuesday. They include Richard Stockdale, Dustin Perry, and Christopher Brooks. All of them face similar weapons and conspiracy charges and were ordered held on high-dollar bonds, especially for Stockdale, who's already a felon on probation.
Now, since you are currently out on bond, count one will be raised to $1 million.
The men are among at least 10 people arrested so far who are all members of the American Front, a group the Anti-Defamation League describes as a racist skinhead group most active in Florida and California. According to the arrest warrant for the group's leader, Marcus Fayella, government informants infiltrated the group 2 years ago and learned they were training on Fayella's property, located deep in some woods east of Holapaw. They were training for what Fayella called an inevitable race war. The warrant claims not only was Fayella's intent to kill Jews and minorities, but that he was experimenting with attempting to make ricin, which is a weapon of mass destruction. The warrant also says Fayella would use jugs of water and told participants to visualize the jugs being what he used a racial slur to describe as the heads of African Americans while they were shooting at them. The members would attend mandatory training at Fayella's compound every Saturday. In addition to surrounding his property with barbed wire, the warrant claims he fortified the compound with cement and had a large stockpile of firearms and military-style MREs. Now, the arrest warrant claims that Fayella, the group's leader, was concerned that his group had been flying under the radar for too long. So he was talking about creating some type of disturbance at Orlando City Hall with the hope it would get media coverage and that would help him to recruit new members. Now, we do hear tonight that there may still be more arrests coming. Live outside the Osceola County Jail, Amanda Ober, WESH 2 News.